Hi guys, my name is David. Welcome back to my channel. So in this video, we're gonna be unboxing the Xiaomi S11 Lite, the smartphone I got from Jumia like a week ago or so, and I've been using it and it's fairly okay to the best of my knowledge. So let's get started. If you're excited as I am about hearing this smartphone, so let's get started. It's true that Xiaomi phones are no longer being produced, but the brand still has some fairly good phones which are still in the market at reasonably decent price with some good features too. The Xiaomi S11 Lite is one of those smartphones, and I'm going to show you like some features I found from using the phone. I can say it's okay considering the price I got it for. So I got the phone from Jumia and it took about a week also to be delivered, and I must commend Jumia for that. Considering the phone got all the features specified on the Jumia website. I got all the features on the phone, so thumbs up Jumia. And disclaimer, Jumia is not sponsoring this video, but I would have a link in the description in case you want to get this smartphone from Jumia. So the Xiaomi S11 Lite camera is the future the Xiaomi brand has marketing the phone around. It packs dual rear camera of 13 megapixel and 2 megapixel for autofocus. While for the selfie, it packs 16 megapixel, which is quite okay. I've taken some pictures with both the front and rear cameras, and it is okay as they say it is. The rear camera has a dark light feature that enables you to take picture on the night, and it will still come out bright, as you can see from some of the pictures below. Moving on, I must confess, what caught my eyes, what made me buy this phone was the storage. They said it came with 64GB. I mean, who doesn't want 64GB of storage? So it prompted me to go for the device, and as it came in, it had that 64GB as specified by the company, and it also packs a 4GB of RAM. The phone comes in two variants, 32GB storage and 64GB, so I was a bit skeptical about buying the device, but to my greatest surprise, I got the 64GB. One thing I noticed right out of the box is that the 4GB RAM promised only has about 2.61GB. So only switching on the phone without even installing any app, you just have about 2.6GB usable, which is a huge reduction from the specified parameter. In terms of the display, the S11 Lite features 5.7-inch with an 18.9 aspect ratio, quite portable for people who don't enjoy big screens. It runs on Android 7.1 and support 4G LTE. Well, it's a dual SIM device and is powered by 3030 mAh battery. This made me not want to buy the device, but considering you can have a power bank and so it's still fairly okay. And the phone, it costs about 34,000 naira. 4GB, 64GB, but at 4000, it's quite okay. So, moving on, the things I like about the phone is it's relatively inexpensive, it has good camera and awesome storage. The things I don't like about the phone is its battery is quite low. With all these 64GB, it's quite low. And the fact that you have to choose between having a second SIM or an external SD drive, but considering it has 64GB, it's something you can deal with. In terms of performance, this is where the main thing comes in. The phone comes with an octa-core Qualcomm processor with 1.4GHz processor speed. The device was, I subjected it to a gaming mode test. I played a PS FPS football game or high screen recording and listening to music. I don't believe that you know how robust the things are handled with multitasking. Although at some point the speed reduced, but overall it still performed very okay. You can see some of my highlights from the game I played. So where can you buy this device? If you're in Nigeria and you want to get, or anywhere in Africa, you can get it from Gmail. I'll put a link in the description section so you can click on it to buy it from Gmail, or if you prefer from there, I also have a link to that in the description section. I've been using this device for close to a week now. From my experience with it, it's very decent considering the price, and it comes with a very good specification. But at some point in time, it can't, like, cannot handle multiple applications, which before you learn the specification more often. I would actually recommend this device for anyone looking for a mid-grade device at a good price. I mean, come on, you're getting 64GB storage and 4GB of RAM for close to 35,000, less than 40,000. You can work? Yeah. That's all. In case if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and please subscribe to my channel. Share this video to whoever you may find it useful, and I'll see you in the next one. It's been a while. I know you're thinking the same, but I've been feeling like a moment can't go to waste. I let go of your name.